February. I know our schedules have been really busy, and I thought that, well, let's throw a date out there, because if we don't throw a date out there, it's just not going to happen.
Every day on my way home from work, I saw this area, and just for some reason, I've always wanted to hike, just be dropped off somewhere, and I wanted to set up a camp and go to somewhere else. And because I knew Pinnacle Rock in that area, Nike base and that general area, I knew it pretty well, I was hoping that I'd be able to get dropped off in one spot and hike to that area.
The general idea was to get dropped off on one side of an area of woods and go in, find a spot, be able to camp down, bed down for the night, and then the next morning continue our hike through to the other side of this area of woodlands, and be picked up on the other side in the process using bush skills that we've learned.
And I figured it'd be an easy, small hike, and so I figured that'd be a good starting point for our training adventures. Before we hiked out, I was talking to Estiana Almonte, and she asked where we're headed, and I told her we're headed out towards, off of Long Swamp Road, we're headed out towards Pinnacle via Long Swamp Road. And she got this kind of crazy look on her face, and she says, "Do you know about the little people?"
Usually people don't cross that bridge because it's abandoned on the other side. And there's stories that, like, there's little people over there, like, killed. Like, if you cross the bridge, you get killed or kids get stolen or...
Well, from what I know, very, very limited information, is the area that we were entering was an area of the little people, from what I heard, is an urban legend.
Like midgets in, I've heard like midgets in like black robes with those, what are those things called?
And she proceeded to tell me about the little people that supposedly lived on the other side of the bridge, right where we were headed into the bush.
The insertion point where we were let off, right across the street in the woods, there was four crosses where evidently four people perished, and I don't know if that was caused by the little people or...
My friend Rashad, he's the one that told me that, like, him and his boys went across the bridge and, like, they were chased by something.
How old is this legend?
Oh, wow, it's since my stepfather was a little kid, and he's in his 40s now. So, quite a bit. I will never cross that bridge no matter how much anyone pays me.
She seemed to think they were pretty real. I guess her dad used to tell her about that as a kid. I guess he heard about them as a kid.
We had wandered in the woods for some time, looking at different potential sites for a good campsite. But then Dave led us down into the valley and across a couple ridges, and we found a real nice place right near a creek, and Machine actually found the ultimate site.
The choice of the campsite turned out very well. We had each scouted out for sites.
Well, I think we found a site here, but we're gonna scout around a little more and see what if we could find anything better, and then meet back where we found. So, check out this area.
We had one spot. We started scouting out and moved farther into the area and found some better sites and discussed them.
There's a wider spot over on it's not quite as close to the stream as this, but I think you're gonna have more space to spread out. There is a fallen tree not quite as big as that you could use for a reflector. It would turn us on the other side, I don't know. And it may be a little more secluded from the wind too, I don't know. Okay. I don't know where we lose Ed.
The spots that I found are very wide open.
Okay. Like wide open, like everything wide open,
yeah,
or
wide open. Okay. But they're very flat, and they're big spots. No rocks, nothing like that.
There's no rocks in the base of the one I found either. I don't know if you want to take a look and see before Ed gets back, or
yeah, that's good.
All right.
You find anything good?
Nothing better.
Good. We're standing in my only other thing I found. I don't know what you think of it. It's just another option. and I'm not going to have my feelings hurt if nobody wants to play.
All right, so keep this in mind. Okay. I'm going to type back up, and I'll show you the two spots that I found.
The reason I chose the site, the reason I found the site was it had a good water source and it had good resources for us, and I thought it'd be good for a team. And probably not a solo trip, it's a little bit big for a solo trip, but it was a good team site.
Obviously this site's got the most room, and it seems to have less wind over on the site. We're still close to the river, so we still would be able to get plenty of water. Ed's site's good in the fact that it has the high tree, and it gives us a good good backstop for the fire. The problem is there's not a lot of room there.
That's the only thing I had to say that with that site. There's not a ton of room.
Yeah. As far as Dave's site that I found, I'm a little worried that there might be a wind tunnel over there. I did say if we are going to take guard shifts or however you want fire shifts, we're going to need furniture.
This is the nicest piece of furniture we've had so far. Yes.
Right.
The other one was rotten and wet. Yeah. This is dry.
This is actually a very nice little seat. And if we wanted to, we could even come off of here, build another piece off of here, and you can put a fire pit right in here, put your tents out here. We need to decide. I'm game for any of them.
I think room is a consideration. I mean, we definitely want our space. And
yeah. Well, it's gonna fill up fast once you start putting down the shelves.
Exactly.
That's the only thing.
Yeah.
And then you have gear and you have fire and you have everything else. Right. So, well, I say we pick this site and so get to whatever your name doesn't cry.
I can care less. I'll sleep anywhere. Not like we're gonna sleep anyway, but
yeah. All right. Well, let's make it.